there. Oh, look, they even have water in their seat. Thank goodness.
That's awesome.
Thank you. I hate doing this. Good evening, everyone. Good evening. All right. I'd like to welcome you all to the commencement ceremony for the class of 2023. Let's hear it. So, if you will, please clear the aisles at this time and take your seats so the ceremony can begin, and please have a wonderful evening. Congratulations to all the family and friends. Thank you.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag
of America, to the United States, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty, and justice for all.
Thank you. You may be seated. Good evening. I'm Dr. Corey Franklin. I'm principal here at Glenvar High School. On behalf of everyone here at GHS, I am pleased to welcome you to our 2023 commencement ceremony. We would like to thank members of our Roanoke County School Board and members of our central office staff for joining us tonight. Seated with us this evening, please welcome our Catawba District School Board Representative and Chairman, Mr. Brent Hudson. And our Assistant Superintendent, Dr. Jessica McClung. Assistant Principal, Mr. Tyler Brown. Our Dean of Students, Ms. Tammy Odom. Our Counseling Coordinator, Ms. Teresa Molnar. And our Highlander of Honor for the 2023-24 school year, Ms. Aaliyah Linkus. So today marks an end of an important chapter in your lives. Today you will graduate from Highlander Heaven to prepare to embark upon your next journey. It is both an honor and a privilege to be here tonight celebrating you and the memories we have made together over the years. I still remember the first time I met most of you as you walked through the doors of Glenvar Middle School as sixth graders. To borrow a phrase from Mrs. Duff, you were such tiny little humans back then. But to be fair, you were only 11. You had so much energy that you literally bounced through the halls, off the walls, and off of each other like pinballs throughout the day. You were absolutely obsessed with bottle flipping. It was constant. It didn't matter where you were. If there was a bottle and a flat surface, you guys were at it. Drove me nuts. But you were curious and you were adventurous. Do you guys remember our Friday after school dances? Remember Work by Rihanna and Juju on that beat? Those were the songs of the year. Remember that? If you weren't chasing each other around the gym, because that's what sixth graders do, you were trying to do the running man on the dance floor. That was also the year Stranger Things came out. It was the year of Pokemon Go for some of you. And do y'all remember Snapchat's face swap filter? That came out that year. You were full of vitality and dreams for the future. There have been many, many changes for you over the years. For one, you are taller. You don't bounce through the halls like you used to, but you are still curious and you are still adventurous. Now, though, you are also confident. You are capable and you are ready for what awaits you. As you look back on your time here at Glenvar, I hope you remember the moments that made you laugh, the experiences that challenged you, and the friendships that sustained you. I hope you remember the teachers who inspired you, the staff and coaches who supported you, and the community that rallied around you. These memories are the foundation of who you are today, and they will stay with you for a lifetime. They will remind you of where you come from, and they will help you stay grounded as you navigate the challenges and opportunities that lie ahead. So before you move on into the worlds of career, military service, or college, let's take a moment to acknowledge and honor all of those who stood with you. Seniors, please stand and give a round of applause to your teachers and your families who have loved, advised, pushed, and supported you during your high school years. Thank you. Sorry. To one of the most talented, athletic, and academically successful graduating classes Glenvar has ever produced. Congratulations. Class of 2023, we love you and are excited for all you will accomplish.
Hi, I am Josie Fraticelli, and something we often talk about in band is how the steps we take before actually playing our instruments have a huge impact on the quality of our sound. Things like learning to read music, notes, and rhythm, and even the way we sit and hold our instrument or breathe have a huge influence on how our music sounds. All these things are like tools we have added to the toolbox that enables us to be successful. Mr. Campbell uses the analogy of filling a swimming pool. You first start with an empty pool, and it seems like the hose will never be enough to fill the entire pool with water. But as time passes, bit by bit, the water level rises until finally the pool is full. This is not very different from the reason we go to school. Since kindergarten or preschool, we have been filling our own swimming pools with knowledge and skills that will help us succeed in life beyond high school. Some of us have used water from the Roanoke Valley Governor School or the Burton Center for Arts and Technology, while others have focused on Glenvar. Each of us is filling our own unique swimming pool with our personal experiences. Some people's swimming pools are filled with things like winning state championships, such as back-to-back VHSL Class 2A championships in girls volleyball and girls track and field, and just today, the boys tennis team becoming Region 2 seed champions. Others filled their pools by playing sports on sports teams that didn't win very much, but still provided opportunities to learn skills or make friends. For some, our water level rose by being members of the first ever Glenvar band to achieve Virginia Honor Band status through superior readings in both marching and concert bands. Some filled their pools by going to all district and our all state band or choir. Others filled their pools by performing in concerts on the Glenvar stage. Some of us participated in Glenvar's first ever Winter Guard, while others performed in Franco's plays or Miss Haney's musicals. Some filled their pools through involvement in groups like FBLA, Beta Club, Helping Highlanders, or GBs, while others have already earned certifications as EMTs, cosmetologists, or CNAs. While we have all had our own wonderful experiences that have helped add water to our pools, we have also experienced some setbacks or moments when our hoses became kinked and the flow of water seemed to slow or even stop. The years of dealing with COVID took up a large chunk of our high school careers, and it seemed like we would always be isolated and stuck with online learning. Some of us have had individual setbacks like mental illnesses, injuries, sicknesses, or losses of friends and family. Whatever our setbacks, we persevered, and over time, the water started to flow again. We have now made it to this spot in our very own Highlander heaven, and we couldn't have done it without our teachers, administrators, parents, and friends. Wherever you head next in life, step there with a positive outlook and take every opportunity you have to find new sources of water to keep your pool filled. When we come back for a reunion years from now, I hope to hear about all the experiences that have continued to fill your pool and maybe even make it overflow.
What adventures do you seek on your swift travels to the ocean deep?
What do you expect to find so far away from home? Friend, I'll miss you.
I'll miss you, promise you won't be gone long.
River, on your way.
On your way,
sing out your greatest song.
I'll be here upon the shore, waiting for your safe return.
I am so excited and honored to speak with you all today. It's been such an exciting and eventful year, and I've loved so many aspects of it. As I was planning to write this speech, I reflected on the highs of the past 4 years and began to think of all the things that Glenvar stands for. With that, I decided to break it down. Literally, what does Glenvar stand for to me and to all of us? Glenvar, G-L-E-N-V-A-R. G, gift. First, what a gift and privilege we have in the community of Glenvar. I've had several friends move to Glenvar from different schools in the Valley throughout my 4 years of high school, and they've all explained that there is nowhere else quite like Glenvar. It is such a gift to have faculty and staff who encourage us to be our best. It is such a gift that we have a modern, well-kept building that has mostly working air conditioning and heat, although we all know those rooms that are like negative 20 degrees at all times. It is such a gift to have coaches for our sports teams who lead by example in what it means to be disciplined. But mostly, it is such a gift to be surrounded by such gifted people. Cindy Loader, who has 1.5 million state titles in indoor and outdoor track and volleyball. Nick Louvet, who can play the clarinet and the saxophone like nobody's business. Lauren Frackleton, who is an incredibly talented artist and Glenvar's only AP art student this year. Kennedy Malcolm, who can actually blow the roof off with her insane vocals. While these are just a few examples, make no mistake, each and every one of you is uniquely gifted and talented, and we've been so privileged to experience it over the past 4 years at Glenvar. L, legacy. One of the perks of going to a small school in a little city is that you are truly known by those around you. We can impact, learn from, and guide each other. We can make a difference to each other and to our school, differences that can last years into the future. We have peers that have parents and grandparents that graduated from Glenvar, and we see alumni at football games and school events. Glenvar is the type of place that has a lasting impact on someone, to where people want to return and visit. We can see the legacy made and left by our predecessors at Glenvar, and we can rest assured that we were able to leave a legacy of our own as the class of 2023. E, exceptional. I believe that this is an exceptional school, and you, fellow graduates, are an exceptional group of people. In this ever-changing world, we've had the privilege of being in an exceptional high school set in a beautiful location of Salem, Virginia, that will end up being the launching pad for all the places we'll end up. Even as we travel across the country in the fall and beyond, we can always look back on Glenvar and our time here and consider it exceptional. In nuance. I think back to when many of us were sitting in AP World History with Mrs. Franco, and she explained what the nuance of an essay was. She described it as an all-around associated feeling. This is exactly how I would describe what it's like to be a member of the Highlander community. It's just a feeling, a welcoming, inviting, and wholesome nuance. The inexplicable idea of belonging completely to one school is one that we, as the senior class, are lucky enough to believe in and be a part of in Highlander Heaven. V. Victory. Victory for finally winning a pep rally, our first one in all of middle and high school. It's ironic, really, having the largest class that's ever come through Glenvar and somehow the lowest possible volume at all of the pep rallies. However, we finally did it for the homecoming pep rally. Rushing the gym floor and holding up Sparky Jr. is a feeling that I will not soon forget, and I expect I speak for more of the seniors than myself in saying that. Winning that pep rally was the crown jewel of our senior year and all of our Glenvar career. By crown jewel, I mean Sparky Jr., who will stay here and who we don't even get to keep anyway, but all that matters is that we won and we leave as victors for our final pep rally. A. Altruistic. Selfless. Humble. Glenvar has taught us what it means to have the heart of a servant. We've been shown to put others first and to be kind in every situation, from getting our service hours in for Beta Club to volunteering with GBs and even putting up affirmation sticky notes all over the school. We've learned the importance of altruism and selflessness. Even in the encouragement given by peers in the hallway, Glenvar has taught us to be truly humble. In one of my favorite quotes, C.S. Lewis writes, "Humility is not thinking less of yourself, it's thinking of yourself less." This has been embodied and exemplified in so many ways at Glenvar, and I am honored to have learned from it. R. Ready. We are ready. Because of our wonderful faculty, teachers, parents, and friends that have helped us through some of those really difficult assignments, we've been fully equipped to embrace our future. Whether it be college, the workforce, the military, technical school, or another path, we know that we have the skills and knowledge needed to succeed. Sure, we likely won't ever need to know the quadratic formula or that the mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell, but regardless, we are ready. Right here, right now, on this field, graduating with our friends and cheered on by our families, we are ready to run toward our future and embrace every element of what I'm honored to say we were able to learn here at Glenvar High School. As always, go Highlanders. Thank you.
Champagne with kings and queens, the politicians praise my name. But those were someone else's dreams, the pitfalls of the man I became. For years and years, I chased their cheers, a crazy speed of always needing more. But when I stop and see you here, I remember who all this was for. From now on, these eyes will not be blinded by the lights. From now on, let's wait until tomorrow starts tonight. It starts tonight. Let this promise in me start. Like an anthem in my heart, from now on, from now on, from now on. And we will come back home, and we will come back home, home again. And we will come back home, and we will come back home. Home again. And we will come back home, and we will come back home, home again. Starts tonight. Let this promise